Hello there, amazing and wonderful geeky people of YouTube. So today we are going to have a look at Endeavor OS. And this is not going to be an installation of it or anything like that. For that, I recommend you guys watch a video from the amazing Esnik, and I will have a link down below to that video so you guys can go and check it out and have some fun with that one. I will basically just give you my views about Endeavor OS and what I think about it and why I am using it as my Arch install at the moment. So let's just get into it. I customized the desktop because I don't like the default look and theme of it. It's not my taste, so I just basically downloaded a theme and I put in, you know, some icons and chisels like that. Also, the theming of the Calamari installer is really ugly, again, in my opinion. I wish they would theme it a little bit better. I get what they are going for, but it looks like it's Windows 95 theming mixed in with some sci-fi buttons and stuff like that, and a color scheme that I don't really care for. But the color scheme could look great if you did it, like, you know, in a better format. Why I like Endeavor OS is that you don't really get much out of the system, out of the bat. You know, the Calamari installer gives you a selection of what the desktop environments you want to install. You get options to install online or offline. Use, you know, the online repositories, or just install it from the CD or DVD or ISO or whatever, however you will call it. So we really like that. Xenon used to be my main driver on Arch, go to for Arch, but Endeavor OS has started to become that for me, for the fact that this is going to sound a little bit crazy, but when I boot up and shut down Xenon OS, it's slow. It boots up to the desktop, and then when I log in, it takes like a 10-15 seconds before it logs in and all that. And I have a suspicion it's all of the extra stuff that he has incorporated. And also, I am in a VM with my Arch installs because I do dev work on the Arch, I do testing and stuff like that. I don't do anything that you cannot do in a virtual machine running Arch. So I don't see any reasons for, you know, buying an extra hard drive or splitting a hard drive. So therefore, I don't need all the gaming stuff that I get with Xenon. If I wanted to game on on Arch Linux and stuff like that, I will probably still go back to Xenon OS. But I like that you get the bare minimum here, the options to have a bare minimum system. And Endeavor OS is still kind of like a new system or a new development team. They are a continuation of a discontinued project. Like some of the community managers, community members, you know, they just said, like, that's continuing the same spirit of, I can't remember what this to be, it's Arx Bang or I can't remember, something like that. They basically said, you know what, let's continue this one. And they are doing an amazing job, and that's what I will go and talk about in this video, is why I think it's a great distribution. And I will not go so much into technical details, because it's underlying it, it's Arch, it's using the latest Arch kernel libraries and all that shit. It's using XFCE, the latest XFCE with all the shizbangs and whatnot. And they don't really give you anything new to the table. They have this welcome screen that you can turn off and stuff like that. You can get help, you can see the welcome's change log and stuff like that. I like that they are putting a little bit of humor in it with like emotes and stuff like that. It's something that I miss in a lot of distributions, and they all try to be so seriously, or take themselves so seriously, that, oh, we are here to take over Ubuntu and Windows and stuff like that. I like that they are putting a little bit of casualness or humor into it here. So this is their welcome tool, and you can see I have opened most of these tabs up here in the Firefox. We'll look at them after we talk about this one here. After the install, they give you a way to update the mirrors, which I really, really like. You can go in here and you can choose a lot of options. You can update the system. It should be updated because it just did that. You see here, no updates. It takes system issues. There's no system issues. You can do, you can upgrade it to the latest Endeavor, change display manager. And see here, you can go in and DDM, LXDM, SSDM, which is really, really good if you're changing desktop environments. So just close that down. You can set the Endeavor wallpaper. I actually don't like the Endeavor wallpapers. You can set the XFCE vanilla theme, and you can use the XFCE Endeavor OS default theme. So let's say you fuck up a theme or something like that, you can go in here and you can be, oh, just reset me to standard, or reset me to Endeavor OS. They have a package manager. I think they would just go in here and talk about Endeavor OS and how to use Pac-Man and package managers and stuff like that. You have AUR and Yay, hardware, network, Bluetooth, NVIDIA users. Basically gives you a guide on how to install NVIDIA. They have their own little NVIDIA script that you can install, and then you can use that one, which is really, really cool. So it's a neat little tool. And there's also here you can get more applications. You can, you know, get a firewall and stuff like that. I like that. Oh, there's Blueberry and Blue Man. So there's two Bluetooth demons you can install here and run. I like this. It's some of this, like the NVIDIA thing and stuff like that. I would have put that into like a sub menu here or have its own little thing. So people don't have to go into the welcome screen, and they may not think about that they have to see the welcome or go into the welcome app to get NVIDIA to work and stuff like that. There's some of these things in here I will remove from this here, and then just have their own little separate shortcut here on the internet or system here, like have a shortcut here saying NVIDIA installation or something like that, you know, so they don't have to go into the welcome. Because a lot of people, when they see a screen like this, they don't really read it. They just go quickly here, don't show me this anymore. That's it. We are lazy people by nature, so. I really don't like this app here called Packages. I get why they are using it. In the fact that the PowerMac AUR, which I have installed here, which most people are using. This tool here, I get why they are not using this here, because this is, I downloaded this from the AUR and installed this. This is a little bit more minimalistic. I don't know, it may be because PowerMac don't really work that well when we're talking updates and massive uninstallation or massive installation. It sometimes bugs out, so that could be the reason. I would love to see them tackling making their own installation tool or their own package manager, GUI package manager, or put this in their default repo, because they have their own repo, and then they could just like make a Arch packet and then basically bug fix it themselves or something like that. And if you look here, like the license here is like 2009. Is this even maintained anymore? I don't think it is. It's getting bug fixes. I don't know. Let's go into why I like Endeavor OS and why I think it's an amazing operating system. So if you go in here, this is just their main website. They are talking a lot about the community, and they are one of the more open and community-focused distributions out there that I have seen in a long time, especially under Arch. They give you a tons of information, which I really, really like. Some could say it's too much information or too much news and stuff like that, but I like this. I even go so far and say this is better than Arch Linux, where Arch Linux tends to bombard you with information, like 5 or 6 videos a day and a lot of articles, and it's more for the engineering people, it's more for the computer science people. But this is just like my mom could read this and get something out of it and understand this, which I really, really like. They are really dumbing it down without sounding too condescending, if you get what I'm saying here. They are trying to make it accessible to everyone and not just geeky, nerdy programmers and stuff like that, which I feel Arch Linux is catered to more towards, because it's a lot of technical blah 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 and all that shit, which a lot of people don't want to, you know, basically listen to, and they have no indication of learning all that shit. And they have one of the best Wikipedias for newcomers here. I even will go and say that their Wikipedia is better than the Arch Wikipedia for one simple reason. If you look at this, and then let's just go in here and do like, if you compare this to this, get what I'm saying here? This over here, the Endeavor OS, is way more user-friendly, it's way more digestible for non-programmers, non-nerdy, technical, geeky people and all that. This is kind of the Arch Wiki here, which is amazing, don't get me wrong, and it gives you a lot of information, but it's kind of like a mechanics manual to how to like calibrate an engine, or an electrical engineer's handbook on how to, you know, use a spectral analyst to a component and stuff like that. It gets way too technical, way too fast for a lot of people, but this is, I will not say the bare minimum, but enough information and enough technical babble to satisfy and be easily digested for non, you know, programmers and geeky and nerdy people. Basically, this, I feel this is more readable for my mom, my brother, my co-workers and stuff like that, where this is really, really amazing and good for distro developers, programmers, technical geeks and stuff like that. You get what I'm saying here. They both have their merits. I just think this is way more user-friendly than this. So that's also one of the reasons why I really, really think that Endeavor OS has a really, really good stronghold. And then their news site here, like I said, they give you a lot of good news and information, and they are not afraid of pushing things back if they need. Postpone it, like here, the net installer. Like, they're like, oh, it needs more work, we are pushing it out to another date. I like that. We're getting into a mentality from programmers and basically any tech companies nowadays that if we set a release date, it has to fucking be that release date, even if it don't work and stuff like that. So I like that they are doing all this. And if you go in here to their forums, they seem to have a really, really friendly and active forum that's really, really kind of like in the Manjaro mentality, where it's user-friendly, it's easy to understand, you don't get a much bullshit, and as far as I know, they don't really do this read the fucking manual thing and stuff like that, which I am against. I'm not against that people should learn, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that they should not be willing to learn and stuff like that. I'm just saying that most people, they just want to be told, you push this button, you put this command in, you go over there and do that thing. That's how 90% of people want to live their life on a computer. Then if you go into, like, let's say fitness, they may be more inclined or more interesting in that. So that's where you tell them to read the fucking manual on why hypertrophy is, what rep sets range you should do to get hypertrophy over strength and stuff like that. You get what I'm saying here? Because that's their interest. 90% of people don't have that in-depth interest in computing and open learning system, but still want to use Arch or Linux or Debian or, you know, Mac OS and stuff like that. But they just want, you know, to be told what to do. So they are doing that here in that way that, you know, yeah, here's what you can do. And if you want, here you can also read the manual. That's the notion that I get from people that are active in their forums and stuff like that. You get what I'm saying here. And then they have this one here that I've actually just noticed today, Discovery. That's basically their own little magazine, kind of like the PC Linux OS magazine that they give out each month. This is just like a, I don't know, like a general purpose way, accumulation of Arch articles, Linux articles. Here, WireGuard is included in the kernel 5.6, but what the fuss is about. There's a lot of good articles in here. I'm actually going to read a lot of these articles today while I'm eating some food my mom just brought me, because I'm a lazy fat geek that don't live at home but live in an apartment. And my mom brought me food, so why not? So yeah, I will do that. And it's, again, a really, really great resource that, again, I don't see Argo Linux, Salient, or any other than PC Linux OS is doing this, but any other distribution don't really do that. So yeah, this, if you're not interested Endeavor OS, at least bookmark this little page here and get some news articles, you know. And another thing that I like is their GitHub page. I'm GitHub, GitLab, I don't really give a fuck or SourceForge or what they're using. I just love when people are transparent with what they're doing, transparent with their code and stuff like that. And you can see here they have installed scraps. They have installation scripts, and they have Calamaris tweaks and stuff like that. Packet builds, the Endeavor OS ISO, which I will go into a little bit in a second. Live desktop setting, terminal colors, screenshots, repos. If you are a developer or you want to base your system on Endeavor OS, like you want to build your own Arch Linux derivative, and you want to have an easy way to do it, you can actually base it off Endeavor OS, because they make it amazingly easy, because they have all of this documentation for it. I have actually respawned Endeavor OS a couple of times last year, and I found it really, really, really easy. And this is basically the build directory for for Endeavor OS. It's basically Arch ISO, where they have just giving you, here, this is what we are doing, this is what packages we are installing, you know, our scripts and all that. Customize it from there. And like I said, I've had a really easy time building out of this, also because of this documentation they have down here. It's actually made building an art spin really easy, because you can just take this and then take out the Endeavor OS branding, the Endeavor OS scripts and Endeavor OS programs and stuff like that, and put in your own. But you can still follow these steps down here and use these guidelines, like I did that, like I said, more than 5 times. And here you have like the, what is that, screenshots. There's not really anything in here, but oh, there's terminal colors. Let's see if we can see anything here. So that's kind of like what they have here. And we have the ISO. I think this is how they're building the ISO and verifying it and stuff like that. So yeah, if you're one of those guys out there that want to try and build your own ARS Linux distribution or Respin, but you find doing it with what is it called? Build ISO, or I can't remember what it's called right now, but the ARS, the native ARS way to do it. These guys have already set it up for you, and they give you some basic steps down here that you can do. It's steps that you normally would have to do anyway. They just make it a little bit easy. Like here, they have like a way to fix permissions, because if you fuck up permissions while you're building your ARS ISO or your ISO for your build, something may work and something may not work on your installation, like on your live ISO when you're booting it up. Like I couldn't get my installer to work for some reason, and I spent like a week, and I found out it was because I set the permissions wrong. These guys made it easy for you. So if you want an easy way to build your own ARS distribution or Respin, they make it easy for you. And then, like I said before, you can just check out everything that they included. Like you can say, oh, I want, I don't know, Fluxbox, and I don't want anything that has to do with Endeavor OS. You just take that out and put your own branding in there, your own programs, stuff like that. They make it really, really easy. So yeah, go check it out. Have some fun. Show them some love. They have come a long, long, long way in the short time they've been around. And I really, really love this project. And I see it has a really, really great future. Because this is, in my opinion, art for the masses. They are not trying to be gaming. They're not trying to be an institute of learning or things like that. They're trying to make my grandmother use it and make it easy for her to read it and understand it and stuff like that. So I'll see you all later. Bye bye.